In this tutorial, we'll look at the chimp's general settings. We'll look at show settings, timings, system settings, network settings, and maintenance. Thank you for your interest in the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, and welcome to this tutorial. To learn more about the various parts of the Infinity Chimp Lite controller, keyboard, and screen, you are advised to watch Tutorial 1 and 2, Hardware and Software. This tutorial is based on software version 1.3. If your chimp uses a different software version, the functions or user interface may be different. Please note that we refer to the chimp hardware keys as keys and the GUI software keys as buttons in this tutorial. Show settings. Press the Setup button on the right in the top of the toolbar. By default, the chimp opens Setup with the Show Settings. Show Settings contains general settings relating to the use of the show. We can switch the Autofix Fader and Executor on and off with the checkbox. If Autofix is switched on and we switch page, the console will transfer the fader and executor labels from active cues to the newly selected page. When this cue is disabled, the console will display the labels for the current page. Below is the dimmer operation for the external desk lights. On the rear of the chimp, you will find a 4-pin XLR connection for connecting desk lights. In addition, the chimp keyboard has a backlight, which you can also switch on and off here. To the right, in the overview, we find the Change Pin button at the top right of the overview screen. In the top toolbar, you'll find a button to lock the console. The default code is 0000, which you can change to suit your requirements. Timings. Back to the left-hand section of the show settings. Patches will be looked at in the Patch and Fixture Library tutorial. Here, we'll look more closely at timings. All settings that are made here will be applied as default cue timings when a new cue is created. All timings for individual cues can be subsequently modified. We also find the snap value here, which is used as soon as a function is unable to fade. The percentage specified under snap value indicates the point at which the change takes place between two cues. Press the keyboard button to set this value. We'll set the value at 50. This means that the function will snap at exactly half the time interval. Under Snap Value, we find the default fade and delay times. Select the desired function on the screen. Press the Set button to be able to change the value. We'll now enter 2 and confirm with the Enter button. For each function within a queue, we can assign a standard fade and delay time. Note that from now on, this value will apply to all newly recorded queues. To the right, in the overview, we find the speed masters. We can enter an upper and lower limit for each individual speed master. To change this, we have to select the value and then press the Set button. We now need to enter the new value. In our case, this is 1. By default, the speed masters are set to seconds, but we can also have them work with beats per minute. Select the desired type and press the Set button to change it. If a speed master is set to seconds, the fader will control from quickly to slowly when we push it from the bottom to the top. If a Speedmaster is adjusted to BPM, the fader will control from slowly to quickly when we push it from the bottom to the top. The Fademaster settings can also be adjusted here. The method is the same. A Fademaster can work with both absolute and relative values. Select the desired Fademaster and press the Set button to change it. System Settings. Back to the left-hand section of the GUI. Input/Output will be dealt with in a separate instruction entitled Input/Output WDMX and Network. For now, we'll continue with System Settings. In System Settings, we can change the layout of the external keyboard. Below, we can see the option to test an external keyboard. On the right-hand side, we find the date and time settings. Network settings. Back to the left-hand section of the GUI. Press Network Settings. Here, we can see an overview of the current network settings in the status bar. You can choose to configure your own network or set the CHIMP to DHCP mode. In DHCP mode, an address is assigned to the CHIMP. In our case, we'll use the manual setting so that we maintain a connection with Capture, our visualizer. Once the CHIMP is connected to a network with access to the Internet, we can test the connection with the Test Internet Connection button. The fixture library and WDMX setup are dealt with in separate tutorials. For now, we'll continue with maintenance. This section allows you to update the CHIMP. We can do this in two ways, either with a file loaded from USB storage or from the CHIMP server online, provided that you are connected to the Internet. In addition, we can also see the front panel test, which allows us to check all hardware buttons, faders, and encoders. The display shows the name that is being tested. Everything is working as it should be. In maintenance, we can also calibrate the touch screens. We have one button for the internal screen and one button for the external screen. Calibration can also be carried out with a hotkey combination, infinity plus open S1 for the internal screen and plus 2 for the external screen. And finally, the maintenance overview also shows the firmware version and the release notes. Back to the left-hand section of the GUI. We'll now close everything down with the shutdown. This button has the same function as the hardware power button. We can reboot or shut down. Whichever is chosen, reboot or shutdown, the CHIMP will always carry out an autosave. Thank you for watching this tutorial. Infinity strives to keep its CHIMP-related tutorials and software information up to date. Keep an eye on our social media channels for the latest information on the CHIMP.